Legend, Nomad, and his opponent, out of Mound, Minnesota, 218 pounds, the current international TV champion, it is Greg Gagne. Special referee from WCCO Radio, the well-known Mr. Dark Star. One fall, 10-minute time limit.
Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall along with luscious Johnny Valiant. We're watching Greg Gagne, the international television champion, in there with the Nomad. And Johnny, I just can't let another week go by without trying to at least pin you down. Are you out here now to have a look at Greg Gagne, the international TV champion?
Well, you know, you saw me watching a match that I co-commentated, if you will, along with yourself, Lee Marshall, with Larry Zbyszko, the AWA current reigning champion, as I fixed my hair here. I am impressed with Greg Gagne. I would not be a bit surprised. Maybe the fans would not either if I managed Greg Gagne. I mean, hey, this is a strange business, professional wrestling. And right. The AWA has extended the invitation for me to come up here and to canvas the area and in the seek of perhaps maybe a tag team wrestling combo or singles man. Whatever. I'm just up here for my own specific endearment, okay?
Well, I know you're not up here for your health.
Exactly right.
I mean, you obviously are.
I'm not up here to be with you either, right?
Well,
I'm not up here to try to manage the Nomad, okay? Would you assume that?
I would assume that.
And this referee who looks like somebody from the Nut House. I mean, really? Look at him. He's in awe of these guys. Watch this, Greg Gagne. He's Action Jackson in there, brother.
Yeah, he is. He is indeed. Greg Gagne with a drop kick.
Probably one of the best drop kicks in professional wrestling.
Yeah.
Have you ever told the people about that?
Absolutely. Wait a minute.
I mean, have you ever alluded to the fact that Greg Gagne does have the best drop kick in the business?
Many times. Of course I have.
But I want the people to say that luscious Johnny Valiant gives Greg Gagne a simple fact that he does possess a tremendous drop kick.
All right. Luscious Johnny Valiant acknowledges that Greg Gagne has the best drop kick in professional wrestling.
Right, he goes very, very high, and he has a tremendous impact on that.
Well, that tag match we saw where the titles were changed, the Olympians, Ken Patera and Brad Riggins taking the titles away from Bad Company, the Sensei Patanaka and Paul Diamond, no longer the tag team champions of the world.
Well, something I will say in regards to that match, I know the outcome is neither here nor there in my mind right now. However, Kenny Patera is a very, very strong man.
Yes.
I've known Kenny Patera for a number of years. I've appeared on several cards over the years with Kenny Patera. I know what Kenny Patera possesses.
Well, what do you suggest?
Will you please quit interrupting me?
I'm not deliberately interrupting you, Johnny.
I am just
coronary
situation
trying to ascertain the facts. You've alluded to tag teams more than
exactly.
once. Now you're talking about Ken Patera.
Yes, I am.
I may be trying to ascertain on behalf of the fans that you might want to manage the Olympians, Ken Patera and Brad Riggins.
I may and I may not, but that's what luscious Johnny Valiant's done his whole life, is do whatever he so well pleases.
You know, we're going to see a little bit of that match later on today. Talking about the match in which the Olympians took the belts away from Bad Company.
Well, let me just say this. Greg Gagne held a tag team title at one time.
Right.
Okay.
You have managed tag team champions.
Yes, I have. The fans certainly know that.
Well, you can see where I'm going with this, John. You keep talking about tag teams.
Well, you know, that's where my expertise really lies. You know, the Valiant Brothers, you know, the whole,
right.
whole routine there. As we see Greg Gagne going from pillar to post here with the Nomad.
Whoa. Well, he took him special delivery all around the ring.
He certainly did. He gave him a certified letter in each direction. Tremendous knee left there by Greg Gagne.
Right under the chin of a Nomad.
I can see a root canal in the works there, brother.
Well, you're very complimentary of Greg Gagne.
Well, he shows me a lot.
I'm not going to rule out.
I can't deny the simple fact.
Ooh. Wow.
Aha!
Nobody
the Nomad holds. Pulls one.
He does indeed.
Wait a minute. We're going up here to the upper echelon of that ring.
Here comes the Nomad. Ow! Yikes!
Now that one smarts, my dear friend.
I gotta believe it does.
That one certainly smarts.
Greg Gagne, you're putting the pressure on now.
You know something? It's a strange thing. As I've traveled over this beautiful United States, I have people come up to me. They say, luscious Johnny Valiant, we understand that you, do you still wrestle? And I say, yes, I do. I still wrestle. I still accept a professional bout here and there.
Well, that's interesting.
Funny you should ask, Lee Marshall.
I wasn't asking. That's it. That's it.
That is it.
By submission.
That is in fact it. That is in fact it.
Here you are. You're out here doing color commentary.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dark Star has stopped the match. Your winner in 4 minutes and 10 seconds, Greg Gagne.
Your winner. Champion. You're doing color commentary.
Yes, sir.
You're talking about managing either a singles wrestler or a tag team.
That's exactly right.
And you're talking about getting back to the ring yourself.
Yeah, I never left the ring. See, that's one thing you have to understand. I never left the ring.
Well,
you understand?
I understand. John, I know you are a triple threat. I'm just waiting for an honest
answer. I don't know if I'm a triple threat. I know that I've never left the ring.
I understand. Okay.
Good I love to do the commentary. You know, you're not such a bad guy, Lee. Why don't the people like you? I think you're a nice guy.
Another victory for Greg Gagne, ladies and gentlemen, international television champion. Did you see what happened last week? Did you see Colonel DeBeers in an absolute hysteria when he stomped out of here over what developed between Tommy Jammer, Derek Dukes, and the mercenary from South Africa? We have more about that this week. Stay tuned for that. And also, we're going to show you the Olympians, Brad Riggins and Ken Patera, winning the tag team championships from Bad Company. But right now, I want to talk about Loyal, Wisconsin. I want to bring out the heavyweight champion of the world, who will be in Loyal and Shawno and also Toma. In Loyal, Larry Zbysko, you must face Wahoo McDaniel.
You know, everybody's so concerned. How come I'm not putting up the belt in Jerkwater, USA? Well, you know something, Wahoo, if you are such a great big chief, if you're so concerned about the land and the stars and all the Indian gaga, then why don't you go off to Alaska and help Exxon clean up 9.5 million gallons of oil they spill. You know, because I'm not going to get involved in the fairy tale that this man lives. I'm not going to get involved in his big dream of tap dancing down the yellow brick road looking for Larry Land so he could wrestle the wizard. I've got important things to do, Big Chief. I've got some important heavyweight championship matches coming up in major cities from Tokyo, Japan to Boston, Massachusetts. What we're going to do is just get you out of my hair, because I am the heavyweight champion of the world.
April 21st is the date. Wrestling fans in and around Loyal, Wisconsin, you get ready. Friday, April 21st, you're going to see some tremendous action. Wahoo McDaniel's on the card, as is Bad Company, Paul Diamond and Pat Tanaka. Then Saturday, April 29th at Toma High School, get ready for some of the greatest wrestling action you have ever seen, including AWA Heavyweight Champion of the World, Larry Zbysko. That's Saturday, April 29th at Toma High School at 8 p.m. Major League of Professional Wrestling.
Back to the action in just a moment, ladies and gentlemen. But first, I want to take you back to last week, in case you missed it. A very dangerous situation developed between Colonel DeBeers and Derek Starfire Dukes. And it all started over a match in which Tommy Jammer was challenged by Colonel DeBeers to last 10 minutes without being pinned. The Colonel said if the young man could do it, he would give him $2,500 of his own money. Let's go back and see what happened in that wrestling match.
Diamond Dallas Page telling them, come on, Colonel, we got seconds left to get this done.
30
seconds, only half a minute left. He's got him, Ray.
Oh, he's got him back. He's doing good.
Oh,
there's a kick out. The power of Tommy Jammer. He's a big, strong man. He kicked right out of that.
What power by Tommy
15,
Jammer.
15, 14, 13, 12,
12 seconds.
11,
10 seconds.
10, 9,
he's up.
8, 7,
6 seconds.
5.
I can't believe
4,
it.
3.
He won't
2,
get him. He won't
1.
Get him. And he didn't get him. He didn't get him.
He did not get him.
Jammer stayed in there for 10 minutes. Only a 2 count, says Marty Miller. He did not get him.
I'll tell you what, the Colonel was probably one sad man right now.
Ladies and gentlemen.
And there's Marty Miller with the money. $2,500 to Tommy Jammer. Tommy Jammer wins $2,500.
Ladies and gentlemen,
he did what Colonel DeBeers said he couldn't do, and that was stay in the ring for 10 minutes.
Tommy Jammer.
That was very interesting. And the Colonel just bit off more than he could chew there. And
Colonel DeBeers pays $2,500.
Colonel DeBeers blindsiding Jammer. And he's going after him. He's going after him.
Colonel DeBeers. Paid $2,500 to Tommy Jammer.
There's money all over the ring. Marty Miller, the referee. Oh, Pile driver right into the cement floor here in the arena. Marty Miller telling the referee, or Marty Miller the referee, asking for the bell to be rung again. Colonel Lemieux grabs the money back from Marty Miller. Diamond Dallas Page taunting Tommy Jammer, but Tommy Jammer did in fact stay in the ring for the required 10 minutes. I don't know what Colonel Lemieux thinks he's doing. He lost that $2,500 as sure as you and I are sitting here, Ray.
Well, it looks to me like he's...
Here comes Derek Dukes! Here comes Derek Dukes! He throws a drop kick! He throws another drop kick! He caught him on that one!
He stole the money! He's running! He's going
Dukes has got the money! Derek Dukes has got the money, and DeBeers, Colonel DeBeers, is over the... He's over the side. Let me find out what the heck is going on here.
Well, DeBeers is down. He's out for the count. He is hurt. Derek Dukes left with the money.
I was watching that wrestling match, ladies and gentlemen, and I noticed that Tommy Jammer seemed tired, and that is just not normal for this young man. He's always in excellent physical condition. It was not until 5 days later that the physician who had been treating Tommy Jammer told us that he had such a bad case of the flu that he had advised him not to wrestle that night. Tommy Jammer didn't say a word to anybody, the promoters, no one. He put on his tights and he got in the ring and he did what he said he would do. He stuck out that wrestling match. You got to take your hat off to Tommy Jammer, quite a kid. After the match, and because of what happened in the match, Colonel DeBeers at ringside made some very unusual demands, absurd as far as I'm concerned. And what I want to do now is take you to the Colonel and let you hear what match he asked for.
There's only one thing I want. I want that Kaffer for just 10 minutes.
Now, wait. What? If you're going to put another $2,500 on the line, you're running out of money, pal.
No. I've got money. I haven't even followed it yet. I want that capper because I'm going to teach him some white manners.
Oh, wait a minute.
I'm going to beat him, and I'm going to paint him white.
The good colonel from South Africa, always looking for the edge, always looking for the advantage. He didn't think Derek Starfire Dukes would accept that challenge. But later on, I had a chance to talk to Derek Dukes, and he had an idea of his own about what should happen in a specific wrestling match. Let's go to Derek Dukes and hear his demands.
I tell you what, Larry. I'm going to accept that challenge, Colonel DeBeers. One stipulation, Larry.
What's the stipulation?
If I pin him in 10 minutes,
right,
I get to paint him black.
Paint Colonel DeBeers black?
That's right. Did you see him going around with a black face, Larry Nelson?
No. Very unusual situation for Colonel DeBeers. He now finds himself having to answer someone else's challenge. Last week, I had a chance to talk to I had a chance to listen to Colonel DeBeers. No one gets to talk to him. I wanted to get his response. And now we're going to let you listen to what the good Colonel had to say.
Let me tell you something, Derek Dukes. Who do you think you are? If you would attack a bar of soap like you attacked me from the rear, then you might have something. But until that day, you and I are gonna go and go and go until one of us. There's not going to be a shred left of Derek Dukes to paint white.
Ladies and gentlemen, I couldn't tell if Colonel DeBeers was hyperventilating, if he was having an anxiety attack. All I know is that the man was very unhappy when he heard about the match the way Derek Dukes wanted it. But the promoters have signed it, and that's how it's going to be right here on that next big card. I want to ask Derek Dukes to join me now. And Derek, I want to go over this with you very carefully. Do you understand what's going to happen? If you are beaten, he's going to paint you white.
Yes. Well, I tell you, Larry, I think the funniest thing of them all is not only I don't have to beat him in 10 minutes, correct?
No, you do not. All you've got to do is last 10 minutes, and you can paint him black.
Well, that's more to my advantage because I tell you what, DeBeers, I know I can beat you in that time. So all I got to do is outlast you? Come on, DeBeers. You know, buddy, it looks like you got a little choked up there, huh? It's like a game of baseball. You see three strikes and you're out. The first strike is, DeBeers, you have only one friend. And that's little Shirley Temple running around with you. Strike two, you're in the wrong country, buddy. We don't do things that way in the U.S. of A. And strike three, last but not least, You are going to be painted black and sent back to South Africa. Now, can you imagine that, Colonel De Beers, when you go over to South Africa with a black painted face? They won't even let you in that country, buddy. And then when you turn your way to come back here, we're going to slam our doors in your face, too.
524 pounds. They are the Destruction Crew, Wayne the Train Bloom, Mean Mike Enos, your Destruction Crew. One ball, 10-minute time limit. Your referee, Gary DeRuscia.
Tag team action. You've got Thor and Tom Burton against the Destruction Crew, Wayne the Train Bloom and Mean Mike Enos. Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall and Ray the Crippler Stevens, and this is just how you like it, Ray. Tag team action at its best.
Oh, yes.
Look at these two guys. Boy, are they put together. Wow.
They're not only put together, they're very impressive wrestlers. They've been doing some great things and coming on like gangbusters. They're going to be a team to be reckoned with, I'll guarantee you that.
Both of those guys, world-class power lifters, by the way. I'm talking about Wayne the Train Bloom and Mean Mike Enos. That's Wayne Bloom. He's in there with Tom Burton out of Chicago. Whoa!
I'm going to tell you, Tom Burton is a husky young man, and he's powerful, and Bloom put him right down there.
That's 240 pounds he just shoved down like a sack of corn. Wayne the Train Bloom saying, come on, come on, come on. Come on, let's get it on. Come on, get in the middle with me. Look at the muscularity on the back of Wayne Bloom. When you hear the term cut or cut to ribbon, that's what they mean. When you say somebody's shredded, they're talking about the muscularity on somebody like a Mean Mike Enos or a Wayne the Train Bloom and the power. Oosh. Oh.
Punch right to the chin there, standing position. Wayne Bloom's a mean man. He loves the street fight. He loves to hurt people.
Wow. Oh, vertical body press by Burton. Very nice. Well, I think all that managed to do was upset Wayne the Train Bloom. He's putting the boots to Tom Burton now. Picks him up with a big body slam. Oh, and he throws him, Ray. He threw a man 240 pounds across the ring. He threw him.
Threw him like a football.
Golly. And now going to work on Thor. Now, we haven't seen Mean Mike Enos yet. Oh, there we did. We saw his elbow, and there's the tag. Wayne Bloom tagging off to Mean Mike Enos. You talk about going from the frying pan into the fire.
Mike Enos is a big, strong young man.
Dude. Oh, reversal. Good move by Thor. Oh, backdrop. Oh, got Enos over.
What a backdrop he gave him. Nice arm drag.
Very nice. Boy, this Thor's giving Mean Mike Enos all he can handle and more. Well, I'm impressed with Thor. Young man out of Miami, Florida, 245 pounds. Tom Burton, Thor's partner, saying, we got him. We got him, Thor. Come on, we got him. There's the train, Wayne Bloom. A little concerned about his partner, Mean Mike Enos.
I tell you, this Wayne Bloom is something. When he's sitting still, he's going 100 miles an hour, boy.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He does love to talk. But he's also the kind of guy that backs up what he has to say. Mike Enos works Thor into the corner. Knee into the midsection. Another knee into the midsection. A third knee into the midsection. Headbutt by Mean Mike Enos. Gary DeRuscia trying to back him off. To no avail. He runs him right into Wayne the Train Bloom. And the Destruction Crew makes the tag. Here comes Wayne the Train Bloom. Into the ropes. Off the ropes comes Thor. Shoulder tackle. Down goes Wayne the Train Bloom, and there's Thor all over them.
Brought him right over on that shoulder. Done some damage to Bloom's shoulder that time,
he did.
I believe.
Nicely done. Put his shoulder right into the middle of the mat. Wayne Bloom now muscling Thor back into the turnbuckle. Knee into the midsection. Into the turnbuckle again. Thor. What a great heads-up move by Thor into an arm ringer. Tom Burton saying, we got him, we got him. And he does. Wayne Bloom grabbing the hair. Gary DeRuscia trying to get him to break it up. Bloom, and here's Mean Mike Enos with a forearm right into the throat of Thor, running his face across the ropes. Oh! That's got to take the wind right out of you. Power body slam by Wayne the Train. Tag made. Here comes Mean Mike. And here comes Mike Enos. He's on the second rope. Here comes Enos. He misses with a flying elbow.
Another nice move by Thor when they thought they had him.
He's got to get over there and make a tag to Tom Burton. He's got to get Burton into this match, Ray. He's got it. Here comes Tom Burton. Burton all over Mike Enos. Arm ringer by Tom Burton. Forearm. Tom Burton absolutely having his way with Mike Enos. Enos rams his head into the midsection. A knee lifted. Down goes Tom Burton.
You can see the power in Bloom and Enos are just overwhelming on
this is a great match. Power body slam by Mean Mike Enos, and he pulled him up. Well, you got four guys in here that just going flat out tonight.
I'll tell you what, they all look very good.
Look at this
what
power
is he
move.
Doing
look
here?
Look at this power move. What are they doing? Enos turns him around.
Oh!
Wayne Bloom with a flying clothesline.
Last time,
2, 3, whoa!
I thought he killed everybody.
I thought he took his head right off of him. What a move.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner at exactly 5 minutes, the Destruction Crew, Wayne the Train Bloom, Mean Mike Enos.
Oh, Ray, I hope we get a chance to see this one again as the Destruction Crew picks up their sledgehammers.
Well, you can see why they call them the Destruction Group.
What power. Let's have a look at it. Now, there's Bloom. Oh, man. That is absolute destruction. A well-deserved name.
Yes, indeedy.
Ladies and gentlemen, including that tag team championship match which saw the Olympians capture the tag team crowns. A whole lot more. But right now I want to talk about Loyal, Wisconsin. Friday, April the 21st, heavyweight champion Larry Zbysko stepping into the ring where he must face the great Indian star, Wahoo McDaniel. And Wahoo, he's refusing to put the title on the line. Refuses to.
Well, you know, I can understand that, Larry, because maybe the man just doesn't have a lot of confidence in himself yet. You know, he's the world's champion. Nobody disputes that. But the man has got a call in there. Doesn't make any difference to me whether the title's on the line or not. Larry Zbysko, I want to prove one thing right there in Loyal, Indian country, that I am the best man. You know, we're in that battle royal. I had Manny Fernandez in there, a thorn in my side, didn't pay him attention, and I was eliminated. Well, that's fine. I've eliminated Manny Fernandez. I got a clear head. I'm coming there with one thing in mind. That's to show the people that I am good enough to beat you, Larry Zbysko, take you down and pin you 1, 2, 3, and make you the shortest lived champion of all times. Now, he says that I don't wrestle by the rules and I have no set pattern. You're right. I don't go out and put an arm lock or wrist lock on him. I go there with one thing in mind. Wear the man down, win any way I can. And I want you to understand, I mean win any way I can, and I'm going to do it.
Welcome to the Matt Classic. This week's classic features a match between one of the finest wrestlers to ever come out of Mexico and a man who dominated the sport of pro wrestling in the 70s and the 80s. We'll be right back with this great match. Stay tuned. This week's Matt Classic features Pepper Gomez, who wrestled for the better part of 3 decades and was regarded as one of the most highly skilled and well-conditioned athletes of his time. He was confident he could withstand the brutal Russian bear hug of Ivan Koloff. That's this week's Matt Classic. Now let's take a look.
But he was really a tough competitor. That's interesting you say that, because you look at both Ivan Koloff and Pepper Gomez. The one thing that you don't see, which you see a lot of the wrestlers today wearing, and I'm not suggesting that it's in any way wrong, but you don't see any knee pads here, or elbow pads.
Back in that era, they didn't have the knee pads around. If I'd have knew about knee pads 15 years before I started wearing them, I'd have worn them all along.
Sure.
As a result of not wearing them, I'm just getting over some real serious knee surgery, and a lot of the wrestlers have had tremendously bad knees. Pepper Gomez is one of them. And those knee pads, they really help a whole lot because you can take a lot of shock when your knees, when you're getting knocked down, especially if you're getting thrown over that rope and hitting on the concrete floors and stuff. People don't realize all the bruises and the aches and the chipped bones and the broken bones that wrestlers get.
Well, if they don't, they should.
Pepper Gomez has got two cauliflower ears that look like doorknobs.
Well, Ivan, he's got the... he's not anybody's poster boy either.
Oh, no, he's got all kind of scars in his head and his face, and he's had his shoulders dislocated.
Looks like the referee's going to throw this one out. Can we get a double count out of it?
No, I don't think so.
I'm not sure. Well, yeah, that was it. I think the referee says it's over. Now, the Koloff or Gomez is willing to concede everything. Yeah, this one had a little double count out, but they're just going to chug right hands at each other.
Oh, Pepper's mad. You can see that. He is mad.
Oh, boy. Well, you've been on the other end of that one, huh?
Yes, I have.
This has been great. Looking at Pepper Gomez and Ivan Koloff in December of 1973 in our Mac Classic. This has been superb.
Pepper Gomez and Ivan Koloff, two wrestlers from opposite ends of the world who couldn't settle their differences this time in the ring. I hope you enjoyed the match. I'm Nori Helm. Join me next week for another great Mat Classic. We'll see you then.
Brought to you by Mars.
And again, ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome Nori Helm to the broadcast team. I know you love the Mat Classic, and I do too. Nori, good job. I want to talk about Wendy Richter, ladies' world champion. Yes, she will be in Loyal, and Shano, and Toma. And talk about a coup. Promoter Lauren Jorstad has signed for his professional wrestling debut the super heavyweight arm wrestling champion of the world, ladies and gentlemen. I am talking about Scott Norton. And Scott, come on out here. What a coup for Lauren Jorstad, an incredibly internationally known athlete. I've got to ask you about your debut.
Well, before I want to get into that, I'd like to talk about the Beers and Dukes. I arm wrestled a guy in South Africa one time. He's about 6'5", 390 pounds. He was a pretty arrogant guy, just like Mr. Colonel DeBeers. Yeah, and I just hope Dukes does a good job on him.
What happened in that match? Just out of my curiosity, what'd you do with that giant?
Well, I flashed the man, bro.
You flashed the man. Now, I hope you don't mean what I think you... What does that mean in arm wrestling tours?
In arm wrestling, that means that I put him down in 1 second. I just pounded him.
1 second flat. And ladies and gentlemen, this man making his professional wrestling debut... You look at the dimensions of this man. There's nothing wrong with your TV set. Well, give me some of your size statistics, Scott.
I'm 6'3" and 360 pounds.
What about this arm? What is that?
23 and a half inches.
Ladies and gentlemen, Scott Norton making his debut in Wisconsin. Get your tickets early.
April 21st is the date. Wrestling fans in and around Loyal, Wisconsin, you get ready. Friday, April 21st, you're going to see some tremendous action. Wahoo McDaniel's on the card, as is Bad Company, Paul Diamond, and Pat Tanaka. Then Saturday, April 29th at Toma High School, get ready for some of the greatest wrestling action you have ever seen, including AWA Heavyweight Champion of the World, Larry Zbysko. That's Saturday, April 29th at Toma High School at 8 p.m.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. What we have for you right now here on All Star Wrestling is something you might have seen on AWA Championship Wrestling on ESPN. But in case you didn't, we want to take you back to Rochester, Minnesota, the night that the newly formed team of the Olympians, Brad Ringens and Ken Patera, challenged Bad Company for the tag team titles. Diamond Dallas Page, of course, always a distraction, as are those Diamond Dolls. Let's go see what happened when the Olympians met Bad Company for the tag team titles.
Some of the greatest wrestling they are ever going to see. Head first into the turnbuckle, face first,
elapsed
nose
time.
First.
5 minutes.
We're 5 minutes
five
into
minutes
this match.
Time.
Boy, and they've been going hot and heavy. They haven't slacked off a bit.
Well, this is for everything, Ray. As you well know, you've so many times a tag team champion of the world, and I think Tanaka may have had his nose broken. This is for everything. And I think I may have seen a tooth fly out of Pat Tanaka's head. Gary DeRusha right down there. He's checking to see if he's going to get a submission from Tanaka into a Boston Crab.
Let me tell you, that is painful.
Oh. Look at the pained expression on the face of the sensei, Pat Tanaka. Diamond Dallas Page, he's over there bad-mouthing Ken Patera. He better worry about what's going on with his man, Pat Tanaka. He distracts Gary DeRusha. Watch out for Paul Diamond. Running clothesline, and Reagan's is rocked.
I thought it took his head off. What a clothesline.
Shot by Pat Tanaka.
Right there is a good example of what you have to contend with a manager like Paul or Diamond Dallas Page.
You bet. Thrust kick by Tanaka. Tag made.
Reagan's is hurt.
You bet he is, and he's got the wrong guy in there in Paul Diamond, because if Diamond senses that he's hurt, Diamond will be all over him like a sheep's coat. Oh, back drop by Paul Diamond. This guy loves to hurt people. He loves it. He lives for it. Paul Diamond loves to punish people.
There, Patera making the save. One thing about Patera, too, he's got a mean streak in him.
Oh, yeah. You better believe it.
But if you're going to wrestle the caliber of wrestlers at
all. Oh, into a skull package. Reagan's has him. Kick out by Diamond. Diamond makes the tag off to Tanaka. Shot by Tanaka.
Well, I tell you, Lee, you're seeing it at its best. AWA wrestling. This is what it's all about. You real wrestling.
You better believe it. If you want to see the real deal, then you come and watch the AWA, especially when it comes to your town, and you get an opportunity to see the Olympians, Brad Reagan's and Ken Patera, or the champions, Bad Company. There's Ken Patera chanting to his partner, Brad Reagan's. You come out and see the action for yourself, and you will see, as Ray Stevens said, the real deal. It just does not get any better than this. A very concerned Diamond Dallas Page, and there you see, wrapped up, Brad Reagan's and Pat Tanaka.
Tanaka, if he'd have had that armbar just right, he could have went south with it, but Brad grabbed it with his other hand.
And Tanaka grabbing a handful of hair, but Reagan's will not release the hold. Gary DeRusha questioning Tanaka. We ought to say hi to Dave Persons from Edina, Minnesota, from South Branch Standard. He's here with Gary DeRusha. And he's seeing one of the greatest matches that we've seen in quite some time for the Tag Team Championship of the World. Two. Reversal. Diamond and Patera getting into a little scuffle.
Look at that switch. That's why they're the champions.
You better believe it. And Diamond Dallas Page, he's over there loving it. Said it's just like we drew it up on the chalkboard, boys. Just like we drew it up on the chalkboard.
Well, there's a good example. If you're going to break the rules, don't get caught.
Yep.
And they're becoming masters at it.
The sensei, Pat Tanaka, catching his breath as best he can. His partner, the street fighter from Thunder Bay, Ontario, Paul Diamond, doing a number right now on Bad Brad Reagan's. Reagan's is in a world of hurt. Paul Diamond stomping on the left arm of Brad Reagan's. Into the corner. Whipped into the corner.
Oh.
Reversal by Reagan's. Oh, Reagan's misses shoulder first into the turnbuckle. Roll up by Paul Diamond. Reagan's is locked up. Kick out by Reagan's. What power. Wow.
I'll tell you, you could never sell Reagan's short. He's
no.
Just like a pit bull dog, and he's never going to give up.
Diamond now tags off to Tanaka, the sensei from Honolulu, Hawaii, in there with Brad Reagan's, the Olympian. Tanaka grabbing a handful of hair, moving him over into the corner. Gary DeRusha, the referee, saying, break it up, Tanaka. Break it up. Chop into the midsection. Headbutt and a crushing headbutt. Another chop to the throat by Tanaka. Brad Reagan's is rocked, Ray. He's got to be. Reversal.
There he is.
Oh, man.
If you blink your eye with Brad Reagan's, you're in trouble.
Tanaka looked like he was shot out of a gun. Uh-oh. Paul Diamond got a hold of Brad Reagan's tights. There's the tag. Diamond now the legal man in the ring, but he grabbed a hold of Reagan's long before that. Diamond putting a shoulder into the throat of Brad Reagan's. Now ramming him headfirst into the turnbuckle. I'll tell you, Brad Reagan's needle might be on empty. Maybe not.
Oh,
what a move! What a move! One, two, kick out
kick
by
out.
Diamond.
Boy, I thought it was over right there.
Count of two, says Gary DeRusha. DeRusha right on top of his as always.
Time, 10 minutes.
10 minutes gone in this championship match.
Time.
It's Pat Tanaka and Brad Reagan's. Tanaka ramming Brad Reagan's head right into the turnbuckle. Tanaka still working on Brad Reagan's.
I tell you, they've been wrestling for 10 minutes, and they're going wide open.
Reversal and a backdrop. Oh, man, he launched him, Ray. He flat-out launched him.
There again, I'm telling you, that Tanaka's one tough man. They threw him so high before he went completely out of sight up there in the top of the arena.
But that was Air Tanaka. Tanaka trying to get over the tag off to Paul Diamond. Reagan's trying to get over the tag to Patera. The tag is made. Patera's in. Diamond's in. Patera wants Diamond. Noggin knocker by Patera. Patera's a one-man gang. He's going after bad company.
Brother, his adrenaline is flowing.
Oh,
now.
Man.
He's excited.
Whoa. Boom. Down goes Tanaka. Patera is going berserk. He's taken on both Pat Tanaka and Paul Diamond. And he senses he's got him. He scrubs his boot across the head of Paul Diamond. Puts the boots to Pat Tanaka. Uh-oh. Patera throws Tanaka out of the ring. That's Patera now working over Paul Diamond. Atomic drop. Over the top goes Diamond.
Wow, I'll tell you what, Patera came completely uncorked.
Oh, man. Patera came unglued. And there's nothing Diamond Dallas Page can say to these guys. Their bell has been rung. Patera's got him again. Ken Patera, Naga Knocker, on bad company. And now Ken Patera going after Diamond Dallas Page. Gary DeRuscia steps in the way, says, let's put it back in the ring. Let's put it back in the ring, Ken. And that's where Patera goes. He goes right after Paul Diamond. Gary DeRuscia just getting back into the ring himself.
Well, I tell you, they got the champion rocking right there.
That's Tanaka conferring with Diamond Dallas Page.
Oh!
He tripped Patera. Ooh, a Pearl Harbor job by Paul Diamond.
Well, I tell
and they've got Patera down on the floor. They've got him. Tanaka's got him down on the floor. Another chop to the top of the head by Pat Tanaka. Patera's in trouble. Shoulder first into the ring post. Gary DeRuscia putting the count out on him.
Right there is a good example. Ken Patera let his temper let him make a bad mistake. He turned his back on Paul Diamond. And he got Pearl Harbor and ended up out on the concrete.
And now it's Patera in trouble. Paul Diamond putting the boots to Patera.
Well, I tell you, they're all four pretty equal. You can't ever count one of them out.
No way. Shoulder first again into that injured shoulder. Paul Diamond ramming Patera with that injured shoulder right into the turnbuckle. Well, you talk about a couple of strong guys, Paul Diamond and Ken Patera. Whoa, man. Snap mare by Diamond, and down goes Patera. Here's a tag. The sensei, Pat Tanaka, coming into the ring. Tanaka's got a hold of Patera.
This has been a great match. It's a great match, I'll tell you.
Headbutt by Tanaka. Patera is reeling. He's got to be. Tanaka and Diamond talking to each other, saying, what are we going to do? What are we going to do? I think they sense Patera's in a weakened position here, Ray.
Yes,
I think
they do.
They're setting him up. Here's a tag. They're going to launch Diamond. And he moves. Patera moves. He caught
what a move
on
Patera's part.
Reagan's in the ring. Whoa, what a right hand. Brad Riggins has Tanaka and Diamond, and they're reeling. Into the ropes goes Diamond. Backdrop administered by Brad Riggins. He's got a hold of Tanaka. Tanaka whipped across the ring, into the ropes.
Oh, man.
G2 kick out by Tanaka. You talk about a snap suplex.
Unbelievable.
Amazing. Belly to back. No, atomic drop. Tanaka down. Down for the cover goes Riggins. Two. Kick out by Tanaka. Count of two. Look at the determination on the face of Brad Riggins. Drop kick that misses. What a heads up move by Tanaka.
He looked like he broke his neck. If he didn't have a big neck, he'd have broken
it. Oh,
sure.
Man. Tanaka grabbed enough of the rope to slow his momentum, and Brad Riggins took that ring mat all by himself. Oh, man.
15 minutes. Elapsed time.
15 minutes
15
gone.
15 minutes.
Backdrop by Riggins, and down goes Paul Diamond. Diamond Dallas Page talking to him, saying, come on, get up. Suck it up. Put on the game face. This is why you're a champion. Gary DeRuscia. Paul Diamond throws Gary DeRuscia in the way of the body. The body tackle of Brad Riggins. And Diamond's got Riggins.
He
had a ring. Tanaka had one of Diamond Dallas Page's rings. He called cocked. He cold cocked Diamond. He cold cocked Diamond. Reagans has got Diamond pinned. Where's DeRusha?
He's got him pinned and hooked him all.
Where is DeRusha? Patera throws him in. 1, 2, 3. It's all over. It's all over. It's all over. We have new tag team champions. It's all over. The Olympians Ken Patera and Brad Riggins are the new tag team champions of the world. Gary DeRusha, the referee, calling for the belts.
I'll tell you what, it backfired.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winners of the match,
there they
are, the new tag team champions of the world, the Olympians.
Brad Riggins
and Ken Patera.
There they are, the champions. And there's Diamond Dallas Page. He is fit to be tied. He can't figure out what happened. And there
Patera
they are.
And Riggins,
the new champions.
Your new tag team champions.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're here in the locker room area. You can probably hear in the background congratulations being offered to the new tag team champions of the world, Strongman Ken Patera, Brad Riggins. The Olympians are now the tag team champions. Gentlemen, congratulations.
Thank you very much, Larry, and thanks to all the people. We've been waiting a long time for this. I've waited a long time for this. My partner, Ken Patera, waited a long time for this. We've been listening to these bad company people badmouth us all this time. And we showed you, bad company, that little monkey on your back you call DDP. I tell you what, he didn't help you tonight, did he, Kenny?
He was nowhere to be found when the action got so furious that the building started to smoke. Where was Diamond Dallas Page? It's quite obvious he was hiding under one of those girls' skirts out there because he didn't want anything to do with Brad Riggins and Ken Patera, the Olympians. On paper, they said, it perhaps is the greatest tag team combination in history of all time. And then Bad Company and Page come out and say, who have they beaten, man? Who have they beaten? We have just beaten you two turkeys. That's what it's all about. We are now the AWA World Tag Team Champions, Bradley.
That's right, Kenny. And you know something? We beat Bad Company, and we beat DDP. And I'll tell you what, DDP, anytime, any place. Only this time, I'll tell you what. I think so, Kenny. I think DDP's boots will fit right under his hat.
That's the truth.
Ladies and gentlemen, here they are. They are the new tag team champions of the world. Brad Riggins, Ken Patera, the Olympians. Long may they reign. Oh, the title match. You heard from the Olympians. We're going to close it up right after I talked to Diamond Dallas Page.
Let me speak. When I have something to say, it's important.
What a horrible situation.
First of all, they're not the Olympians. They're the Olymp impotents. I've said it 100 times. Just because they happen to be wearing a gold right now, you know something's the matter. It's not the right thing. Bad Company should still be wearing the belts around their waist. You saw it. You were right there, Larry. Redkins hit. He hit the referee. Knocked him right out of the ring. Come over here. Settle this later, man.
What are you talking about?
Hey, bro, settle it later. I know you're hot about the situation. Hey, I'm the brains behind this thing. I will make it all happen again.
If you are the brains, just listen to me. If you are the brains, who's wearing the tag belts? I'll have them beat.
It's a temporary setback, man.
Temporary setback. That's the livelihood, man. The goal. That's what it's all about.
Paul Diamond is furious. The tag team titles are gone. Your men are at one another's throats. This is rough times for Diamond Dallas.
When something goes down like this, first of all, Larry, people are going to be a little bit hot. The sensei is hot. He's hot. I know he's a little upset. What do you think? I'm not hot. You don't think I'm hot? But the bottom line is, I can get hot. I can get composure. Motivation, inspiration, and stimulation will bring back the belts. You see this right here? He said that on paper, they look good. The O-Imp impotence. That's what we have to say about
the man
that on paper.
Has been ranting and raving. You can tell it in the voice, the hoarseness of Diamond Dallas Page. He is obviously upset.
That's all for this week, ladies and gentlemen. Join us next week on All Star Wrestling, and we'll try to clarify this battle that's going on between Derek Starfire Dukes and Colonel De Beers. Plus, you'll see Wendy Richter defend the ladies' title against the Dazzler. You'll see our Matt Classic and a whole lot more. Join us next week for Vern Gagne's All Star Wrestling.
Steve Bodine and New Bohemian. Now stay tuned for...